Hello and welcome to Pakora Kari. This is the soup stew type thing that you did not know you needed in your life until you taste it, and then it's like, wow. If you've never had kari before, it's like this tangy, soupy deliciousness that's just so creamy and tangy at the same time. I think I've said tangy enough times. I think you get it. It's made with chickpea flour besan and yogurt or buttermilk. And that's pretty much it, a few spices, but really the flavor comes from cooking down that yogurt in the soup. And then you want to put some pakora into your curry. So a nice crispy, crunchy pakora, also made from besan, with this like spongy inside that soaks up all of that tangy goodness. I'm telling you, you want to make this recipe. It is super easy, super simple. You probably already have the spices at home. And that's about it. It takes a bit of time to make your pakora. You do have to sit there and fry them, so that's probably the one thing that takes some time. But really, come on, turn on some music, enjoy it. Why not? The secret to a really good pakora, by the way, you want it to be thick like a pancake batter, and this little bit of baking soda will help get you that really spongy texture on the inside. And also, I add a little bit of corn flour into my batter, which helps it get nice, deep, golden brown and crunchy on the outside. So try those with your pakora. And I dare you not to munch on these while you're frying them. I mean, sometimes they disappear before they even get to the curry. And of course, to flavor our curry, we're gonna do a tarka. Very simple, again, some cumin, some curry leaves, some garlic, some chilies, and that's about it. You wanna throw all this garlicky deliciousness on top of your curry, and you're done. You don't want to soak your pakora in the curry unless you're serving them right away. I like to just keep them separate and just heat and eat as I want them. But that's it. The full recipe, of course, is on roostory.com. And let me know if you try it, what you think, if you've had curry before. Enjoy. And thanks, Mom, for sharing this recipe.